Back to the channel. Before I say anything else, I want to thank you for 100 subscribers. It's an extremely small milestone, but it's a milestone at that, and I want to thank everyone who takes their time to watch my videos. Please continue to like, share and subscribe, as I would really like to grow this channel. Today I will be continuing my top superheroes you didn't know about series, where I talk about heroes from unrepresented groups and I shed light on them here. This episode will be a continuation of my first video about black superheroes. I will also be joined by a few special guests who want to celebrate this with me. So stay tuned. Number 11. I know the title says top 10, but that's just for the algorithm, so take this as me giving you a bargain. Prodigy. David Allein, also known as Prodigy, is a mutant who was part of the New Mutants, New X-Men, Young Avengers, and now he is part of the X-Factor Investigations. He was first introduced in The New Mutants Volume 2 Issue 4 in 2003. David is a mutant with the ability to telepathically absorb the skills and knowledge of anyone within his immediate vicinity. He is able to replicate this perfectly. This means he could essentially learn a foreign language or master a fighting style within seconds. The only caveat is that once he leaves the area where the subject is, he loses all this knowledge, meaning this ability only works on a temporary basis. We soon find out that there's actually a mental block on his powers, which causes him to forget the skills and knowledge he acquires. His powers are taken away during M-Day, but thanks to the Stepford Cuckoos, he was able to keep all the knowledge he had previously attained. This included Wolverine's hand-to-hand combat skills, Cyclops' strategic knowledge, Beast's knowledge of science and biology, Iceman's mathematical comprehension, Kitty Pryde's computer prowess, the magical knowledge of Doctor Strange, and the education and abilities of most of the other X-Men, some of the Avengers, and nearly all of his former classmates. This technically makes him one of the smartest beings in the Marvel Universe. Like, just imagine if he used his powers in a room with Reed Richards, T'Challa, Tony Stark and Bruce Banner. Like, he'll be unstoppable. Who's beating him? Tell me. He was then killed and resurrected as a mutant, so he now has his powers back without any of the mental blocks, which means that, yeah, the guy is the smartest guy around. No one's smarter than him. Number 10, Night Thrasher. Night Thrasher is the hero name of Dwayne Michael Taylor, also known as Marvel's Batman. His first appearance was in 4 issue 411. He founded the team the New Warriors and has been the leader of the team in most of the iterations. He shares a lot of parallels with the Caped Crusader from DC Comics. They both witnessed their parents' death before their very own eyes, and this led both of them to train in martial arts. After creating his own superhero persona, he formed the New Warriors, which was a team that rivaled the Avengers. Night Thrasher has no powers, but he is an expert martial artist, Olympic level gymnast, a skilled weapons designer, and he has a genius level intellect. He wears an armor which enhances his strength and houses a utility pack with various gadgets like explosives, smoke bombs, flares, gliders, and an active camouflage system. Number 9 will be Black Goliath, and I will be giving that to Daniela to tell you about him, so take it, Daniela.
Hi, my name is Daniela and I'm going to be talking about Black Goliath. So first of all, he made his first appearance as Avengers in issue 32 in 1966. He was an employee of Stark Industries who were tasked with helping Hank Pym, the original Ant-Man, return to his normal size, because roughly at that time Pym was stuck at 10 feet tall. He then basically took the Pym particles that Ant-Man uses to grow, and he further improved on it by eliminating any side effects. So basically this led him to become the hero of Black Goliath, being that he possesses Pym particles. He is able to grow at a size of maximum of 25 feet. This grants him super strength, and it has been recorded that he can actually lift up to 5 tons. So yeah, that's Black Life.
Thank you for that, Daniela. Next, we'll go to number 8, which is Batwing. David Zavembe, aka the first Batwing, made his first appearance in Batman Inc. issue 5 in 2011. He was born in Tanasha, Congo, and when his parents died of AIDS, he was drafted as a child soldier. He soon became a well-respected young police officer, handling crime in his home city. Bruce Wayne soon took interest in the young man, and he gifted him with the Batwing suit, as well as allowing him to join Batman Inc., which is an establishment that includes many individuals that act as Batman's global representatives. David became the Batman of Africa. David is equipped with the Batwing suit, which enhances his strength, allows him to fly, and is resistant to bullets. Lucas Fox became the next Batwing after David retired, but I will discuss him in another video. Number 7 will be Mr. Terrific, and I will give that to Alpha Kings 123 to tell you about him. So take it from here.
Yeah, it's your boy Alpha King 123. Yeah, shout out to the Caramel Drizzle, aka Justin, aka the Hokage, aka the Raikage, because he's light skinned. You feel me? Fam, you man, today we're gonna be talking about my nigga right here, Mr. Terrific. Mr. Terrific, for those of you who didn't understand my dialect. So, obviously, Mr. Terrific is a DC hero, a black DC hero, okay? Now, let me tell you something. Come here. This dude is actually kind of dope. Mr. Terrific, also known as Michael Holt, is the third smartest man in the world. He is also a self-made billionaire. I think it's billionaire. Doesn't matter. The nigga rich as hell, okay? Okay, cool. He is the CEO of Holt Industries. Think of it like Wayne Tech, but black. You know what I'm saying? Okay. But obviously, I know you guys want to get into his abilities and all sorts, okay? Now, sadly, he ain't got no superpowers, okay? But what you guys might not know is he is a genius inventor, okay? But not only that, think of him as a black Batman, okay? He possesses a genius intellect. Bilingual, is it multilingual or something like that? He knows a lot of stuff, okay? He has a PhD in multiple scientific professions, such as chemistry, physics, law, medicine, psychology, and all sorts, okay? I'm looking over here because the notes are here, okay? He is at peak human condition. He can arm wrestle you and snap your arm off. He possesses peak human reflexes, agility, stamina. Blood, my guy is a super athlete. No super soldier serum.
Yeah, am I right?
Because he's a genius inventor, of course, he relies on his wit and his tech, right? So his most famous piece of tech are the T-spheres. The T-spheres, think of them as like the Sage of Six Paths balls behind him. They are capable of doing all sorts. So they're capable of reconnaissance, stunning, and doing all sorts. Blood. Long story short, Mr. Terrific is by far one of the coolest black heroes of all time. That is no cap, okay? So yeah, man, that just concludes everything that I got to tell y'all about goddamn Mr. Terrific. Terrific, okay? Big shout out again, Caramel Drizzle, for allowing me to come onto his channel. Obviously, give you man a So thank you again, man. You man, enjoy the rest of his video. Goddamn!
Thank you, Alpha King. Now let's get to number 6, Bling. Roxanne Washington, professionally known as Bling, is a mutant and part of the X-Men. She made her first appearance in X-Men Volume 2, Issue 171. She is the daughter of two notorious rappers in California. After she grew tired with living with her parents and putting up with their lifestyle, she opted to join the Xavier School for the Gifted to better herself. She soon graduated into the X-Men and has become a well-respected member of the team. Bling's bone marrow is capable of producing diamond shards of varying quality, also giving a crystalline appearance to her skin and physicality. She is also able to expel diamonds from her body and to use them as projectiles. And due to her being made out of diamonds, she is almost invulnerable and has superhuman strength. The only drawback to her powers is that she is stuck in this crystalline form. She can never go back to, you know, an organic human flesh kind of form. Bling's character has also been the subject of a lot of controversy due to her name and origin hailing from black stereotypes and hip-hop culture, but if you can see through this ignorant decision, you'll find that she is a very interesting character. Number 5 is Hardware, and I will be giving that to Jinx to tell you about him.
Okay, it's your boy Jinx, and today we're going to be talking about this guy.
this guy right here. Now, his name is Hardware. So, Hardware is a DC black hero who is quite similar to Iron Man in the sense that he builds his own stuff, he flies in a suit, bloody bloody blah, but he black. So his first appearance happens in the Hardware issue number 1, The Man in the Machine, chapter 1. Clearly, yeah, it's got to be the first chapter in it. But yes, his origin, right? So his name is Curtis Metcalf, and he was born in one of the poorest parts of Dakota. And like many inventors growing up, he liked to like dismantle stuff to just find out what they were made up of and also how they essentially functioned. Now, his dad was also a police officer, which you kind of get the sense of justice and crime fighting from. So growing up, he was found by a technological corporation business guy by the name of Alva. And as a superhero later down in the series, he essentially tries to thwart Alva's business, but not the technological part of the business, but more of the darker sides of Alva, which is the drug empire, the crimes, the illegal stuff. And he knows this because he knows he is fighting Alva in the dark, but Alva has no idea of this, that the person fighting him as a superhero is the same kid he put through school, helped get 6 degrees here, whatnot. And funny enough, the parts he uses to build his suit as Hardware come from Alva Technologies, the corporation of the crime boss he's trying to bring down. Later in the comics, Alva would find out the true identity of Hardware, the hero who's been thwarting his business, and willingly decides to back Hardware in what he does by offering him a position as a vice president in Alva Technology. Now, with this position and new post and backing, Hardware is able to further improve his suit to that, and then he just looks cool like that. And later on, he also teams up with Superboy, Superman, and Steel to fight against an interdimensional menace called the Rifts. So some of you may be wondering what his powers, because I essentially said he's basically a black Iron Man. Well, he's got agility, blast power, flight from his suit, he's got gadgets, he's smart, so he's got intellect, he's invulnerable, he's omnilingual, brother can speak languages, all of them. And he's got a power suit, so he can also block bullets to a certain caliber. And he's got super strength because of like the muscle fibers he incorporated into his suit. And he's also really good at unarmed combat. And that is all you need to know about a black DC superhero, Hardware. On to the next one.
Thank you so much. Now I'll be talking about Empress. Number 4, Empress. Empress was a member of the original Young Justice team. She first appeared in Young Justice issue 16 in 2000. Her real name is Anita Fights, and she was inspired to become a hero when she saw Arrowette stop a thief in a shopping mall. She had a successful run with Young Justice, and she proved to be a very powerful and valuable ally. She only left the team because her parents were killed and reincarnated as babies. Yeah, the Young Justice comics were really weird. There was even a villain they faced that had the power of big breasts. Anyway, Anita retired so she could look after her parents. Unlike her inspiration, Arrowette, Anita actually has powers. In fact, she was taught how to use magic by her grandmother, Oya. Her magic powers allow her to teleport, create hex shields, and control minds. Number 3 is Excess, and I'll be giving that to Esther to tell you about her.
Hi guys, my name is Esther, and I'm going to be speaking to you about XS. Jenny Ognatz, also known as XS, is a speedster. She is related to Barry Allen from the 30th century and is also a part of the Legion of Superheroes. Now, Jenny made her first appearance in Legionnaires issue 0 in 1994. She is the granddaughter of Barry and Iris Allen from their time in the 30th century and is also the cousin of Bar Allen, more famously known as Impulse. She was thought to have no powers, but when she was put in a situation where her father's life was in danger, her powers kicked in and she discovered that she had super speed. Like most speedsters in the DC comic universe, XS is connected to the Speed Force. This allows her to move at a tremendous rate. It's been stated that she can run 10 times the speed of sound. Although this is nowhere near as fast as her grandfather, she's able to run on water, phase through objects, create vortexes, and even break into the time stream without the cosmic treadmill, which is a massive deal. She also possesses the Legion flight ring, which allows her to levitate.
Thank you so much for that, Esther. Number two is Nubia, and Molina will tell you about her.
Some people may call her the Black Wonder Woman. I personally will have to disagree. Wonder Woman is the white Nubia. However, both of these statements could be incorrect because after they were made by clay, Nubia with black clay first, then Diana with white clay, they were both brought to life by Aphrodite. So does that make them Greek? Two sisters, two different shades who are Greek. Nubia first appeared in Wonder Woman 204, the second life of Wonder Woman, where Diana was challenged by this mysterious warrior who called herself Nubia. She has amazing powers such as the ability to glide on air and superhuman strength, as well as this badass magical sword that was created by the god of war, Ares, who kidnapped her and trained her to be the strong and talented warrior that she is now. She will eventually have her own comic and young adult novel, which I'm extremely excited about. This will be amazing. It'll just be great to see more of this legendary DC character.
That was interesting, right? Okay. Now, number one, Sync. Lastly, we have Everett Thomas, known on the field as Sync. He is a mutant who was part of the Generation X team. He first appeared in X-Men Volume 2, Issue 36. He was recruited by Emma Frost and Banshee to join Generation X, which was a team that was trained to become the next generation of X-Men. Everett subconsciously creates an aura which allows him to be in sync with other superpowered beings within his vicinity. This results in him gaining any powers they possess. He is also able to use the aura to track other mutants. This makes him incredibly versatile, and in most cases he can use the powers of others at a much higher degree, like he was able to create massive explosions with Jubilee's ability. This was something she was unable to do at the time. This leads me to think that he can use any power at their full potential. It's even been theorized that with practice, Sync will be able to permanently retain the powers and abilities he acquires. This would make him an Omega level mutant because there will be no limit to his abilities. All he will need to do is take Deadpool's healing factor, Scarlet Witch's reality warping abilities, and maybe Prodigy's telepathic power, and then he'll be unstoppable. Like, who's gonna beat him? Especially if he's able to access those powers at their full potential. Thank you so much for watching this video, and thank you to everyone who got involved with this video. A lot of them did their own research, so I really, really appreciate that. And all their socials will be linked in the description, so give them a follow and subscribe to Alpha Kings and Jinx's YouTube channel. They do reactions and stuff like that. Stay safe, have vitamin C, drink water. Bye.